morning. I want to welcome everyone to this year's Memorial Day ceremony. And being here in this beautiful spring morning reminds me again how proud I am of this community for providing a place where people can come and reflect on the sacrifices that others have made. This patriotic statue of soldiers, both a man and a woman holding a flag, gives us another focus for a reflection on the service of others and the freedoms our military have fought to protect for many generations. It's important to have a place to come and remember those who are willing to serve our country and those that lost their life defending our freedoms. I'd like to take, too, a special moment and thank the former Carmel Clay Veterans Memorial Corporation for providing this lasting reminder and tribute to our veterans, for our citizens of Carmel to enjoy for generations to come. I was just looking at these young trees over here thinking how this will look in 50 years. It'll still be a beautiful spot. And if you're a former member of the Veterans Memorial Corporation, I'm not going to have you stand up, but raise your hand up so we can all recognize you. Thank you. We are here today to remember those that have dedicated their lives to preserve our freedom, the freedom that makes America a great nation. And while we should never take those freedoms for granted, it's even more important during times of conflict to remember why we fight for freedom. Many of us have loved ones that are still serving overseas, and we must always remember to show them support as well. We will now begin the flag-raising ceremony with the Carmel American Legion and Veterans of Foreign Wars. First, we're going to raise the flag of the United States of America. Next, the flag of the U.S. Army. Next, the flag of the United States Marines. Flag of the U.S. Navy. Flag of the U.S. Air Force. Coast Guard flag. And the flag to remind us of our prisoners of war and those missing in action. Please welcome Reverend George Davis, the Carmel Police Chaplain, for our invocation.
Would you join me, please? Gracious God, we come to honor and remember those who gave their all for the promise of democracy. May we be grateful and humbled by all they laid at the altar of freedom. May we give them worthy recognition, comfort all who mourn them, and be with our brothers and sisters who face the perils of war. Grant them courage and strength. Amen.
Now please welcome our Clay Township Trustee, Doug Callahan, to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please join me. I pledge the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now please welcome Cynthia Ensign Baney, who will perform the national anthem. Cindy. It's always a pleasure to have Cindy Baney as part of our Memorial Day ceremony. She was honored as Carmel Clay Teacher of the Year in 2012 and has received Carmel's Rangeline Pioneer Award, which is the highest honor Mayor of Carmel can bestow. She's also the choir director for Carmel Elementary and is the daughter of Dorothy and Bill Ensign, and Bill, as we all know, I think, is the former president of the Carmel Clay Veterans Memorial Corporation. Later in the program, you will hear her song, Honor, that she wrote to honor her father and all other veterans. I would now like to introduce our keynote speaker. Carmel resident, yes, please be seated. Thank you. His service with the U.S. Army spanned 29 years. He's a graduate of West Point. During the 29 years, he was assigned to numerous command and staff positions, including the Deputy Commanding General of the 24th Infantry Division at Fort Riley, Kansas, Chief of Crisis Action Planning for the Joint Chiefs of Staff at the Pentagon, Commander of the 3rd Brigade of the 1st Brigade of the 1st Armored Division in Fort Lewis, Washington, Commander of the 1st Battalion, the 37th Armored Regiment, 1st Armored Division, an assignment which included a combat tour of duty in Iraq as part of the Desert Storm campaign. As a captain, he also launched the RLTC program at Indiana University and Purdue University in Indianapolis. He holds a Bachelor of Science degree in engineering from the U.S. Military Academy at West Point and a Master of Science degree in Industrial Engineering from Purdue University. He was selected to participate in postgraduate studies in national defense and international affairs at the U.S. Army War College. In addition, he has studied program management, Defense Systems Management College, and finance at the Wharton School of Business. He has served as president of the General Douglas MacArthur Chapter of the U.S. Army Association and is a member of the board of the Hampton Roads USO. He is an associate fellow of the National Defense Industrial Association and chairman of the U.S. Army Indianapolis Community Advisory Board. Presently, he is Vice President of Military Programs for Allison Transmission. He and his wife, Gia, live in Carmel and have 4 children and 6 grandchildren. Please join me in welcoming Brigadier General Edward Dyer.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, for that kind introduction, and thanks for your vision and your leadership, which led to the construction of this wonderful memorial here in Carmel. Good morning. Thank you all for taking the time out of your busy schedules to join us today to honor our fallen veterans and all veterans who have served or are serving today to defend the freedoms that we all hold so dear. I want to first start by thanking Mayor Brainard for the invitation to join you. And a special thanks for those responsible for organizing this ceremony. As you can imagine, something like this doesn't just happen. It takes a great deal of planning and preparation and most especially dedication. So to all of you, a very special thank you. I'm going to talk today about the special bond that exists among veterans. Those here today, some still serving, some no longer in uniform, and those that lie peacefully in cemeteries around the country and around the world, some just blocks from here, and especially the bond that exists among those veterans who have served in combat. But before I do, I want to make one other special note on this Memorial Day weekend. You know, we often talk about the special sacrifices that our men in uniform make. But the full reality of war hits the soldier, sailor, airman, marine, or Coast Guardsmen only when they meet the Gold Star mothers, Gold Star families. For those who don't know, Gold Star families are those who have lost a loved one in combat. And I know we have at least one here with us today. Any veteran who has returned to face the families of comrades lost in combat knows exactly what I'm talking about. I have had the unfortunate honor of presenting our nation's colors to several Gold Star mothers. And I have watched the colors presented to the mothers of some of my closest friends, high school teammates, and soldiers that I served in combat with for over 25 years. Only then does the true meaning of those deaths in action strike home. For the men who died, it was often sudden and painless. For the men and women who watched them die, it was just one more of those things in combat on which not to dwell. But for the Gold Star families, it's a wound that can never heal. So if it's true that those who make the greatest sacrifices reap the greatest rewards, then clearly there's a seat reserved for them at the right hand of the Almighty. Well, thanks in large part to all who have served in uniform. We've lived in such safety and comfort for so long in this country that, frankly, for many Americans today, sacrifice means little more than a few extra pennies at the gas pump. But those we honor today understand truly the sacrifices that we must be willing to make. It seems to me that what we think of as success in America is significantly different than what most of those veterans who lie silently would have considered success. We can read in the newspapers and in Forbes magazine of men and women who have been financially successful in this country beyond our wildest dreams. But as they grow older, they realize they have no real buddies, no real comrades, no one who was willing to die for them or who they were willing to die for. Veterans, on the other hand, share a special bond, a bond that, once formed, lasts a lifetime and beyond. It is why, if you look around today, so many of those gathered here today are veterans. As a famous infantry battalion commander in Vietnam, Lieutenant Colonel Hal Moore, commander of the 1st of the 7th Cavalry at Iodrang Valley, once said, "American soldiers in battle don't fight for what some president says on TV. They don't fight for mom, apple pie, or the American flag. They fight for one another. And therein lies the bond. It's a bond felt standing amongst the parapets at Yorktown, where I have stood. or on Seminary Ridge at Gettysburg, where I have stood, or on the beaches of Normandy, where I have walked, or in the jungles of Bataan, where I have marched, or in the deserts of Southwest Asia, where I have fought, or right here in front of the Carmel Clay Veterans Memorial that I visited often when I lived right at the other end of this beautiful reflecting pool. It's a bond that we feel to our marrow. It's a grip of a far-off hold. We use this bond as a source of inspiration and pride. It's a part of our ethos. Now, some may struggle with the horrors of combat that we witnessed and the bond that was created during those times. But it may be the understanding that together we were better than we had ever been before. Maybe better than we would ever be again. Or the idea that the memories might someday be a source of strength and inspiration. Those who have served, especially those who have served in combat, have experienced the contradictions of the sacrifices that we make. The nights were darker and the stars were brighter than any we have ever seen. The water tasted better than any beer that we have ever sipped. The heat was suffocating, the cold cut like a knife. Our feet hurt constantly, and sleep was a luxury. We were lonelier than we ever imagined, yet we were with the closest friends we've ever had. Once you've experienced it, you never forget. This tradition of buddy loyalty can be traced through generations of American warriors, even to our English forefathers. Students of history know the story of the English army at a small French village called Agincourt, almost 600 years ago on October 25th, 1415, St. Crispin's Day. The English king, Henry V, waited on a muddy battlefield with his archers and swordsmen to face a French army that vastly outnumbered his. When he addressed his men, he didn't talk about national strategy. He didn't talk about the poor intelligence or the questionable decisions that put his men at such terrible odds. Instead, he talked about what made soldiers fight and what would allow them to prevail against such terrible odds. He was quoted in a famous Shakespeare play. Henry said, "This story shall the good man teach his son from this day ending until the ending of the world. But we in it shall be remembered. We few, we happy few, we band of brothers. For he today that sheds his blood with me shall be my brother. And gentlemen now abed shall think themselves a curse they were not here, and hold their manhoods cheap, while any that speaks that fought with us on St. Crispin's Day." The veterans assembled here today and at countless ceremonies like this across the nation this weekend inherit that spirit of St. Crispin's Day. They know and understand the comradeship that those whom they protect will never know. A veteran whose name is lost to posterity made this observation. "I now know why men who have been to war yearn to reunite. Not to tell stories or look at old pictures, not to laugh or weep. Comrades gather because they long to be with the men and women who once acted at their best. Men who suffered and sacrificed, who were stripped of their humanity. I did not pick these men. They were delivered to me by fate and the military. But I know them in a way I know no other men or women. They were willing to, I've never given anyone such trust. They were willing to guard something more precious than my life. They would have carried my reputation, the memory of me. It was part of the bargain that we all made, the reason why we were willing to die for one another. As long as I have my memory, I will remember them all, every day. And I'm sure that when I leave this world, my last thoughts will be of my family and of my comrades. Someday we will all join those veterans who rest today peacefully, hopefully around some everlasting campfire. We can share a steaming canteen cup of coffee and a sea ration or a piece of hardtack and once again embrace and share with each other the comradeship of veterans, while others can only watch and wonder. So until we meet again, thank you for your service. Thank you for your sacrifice. God bless you all, and God bless this great nation. And thanks again for being here today.
Thank you. That was very appropriate for this day. I also want to recognize, I see in the audience today, we're fortunate to have with us former Mayor Jane Ryman. So let's thank her for her service as well. At this time, Cindy Ensign Baylor is going, Beanie will play her song, Honor, her original song that she wrote.
Honored servants, safekeepers of the land. And
this time, as is our tradition, please join Girl Scout Troop 330 in placing carnations at the base of the statue. Mr. George Davis will now lead us in the benediction.
Would you join me? Merciful God, with appreciation for all who are remembered here, with gratitude for all who have served the cause of freedom, for all who serve the public good, and for those who would keep us safe, bless our great land that with sound strength and sure purpose we may nourish and preserve this country as a haven of justice and peace. Amen.
Thank you for coming today.